Ryan Garcia called out Vergil.
Yes.
And you said we're sparring Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Did he respond?
Yeah, but I don't want it for sparring. I want it for a fight. What do we want to?
He ain't gonna make it.
For a fight, he won't. I know, but I know, but you know.
Well, he's suspended for another 8 months.
Yeah, but when he comes back, if we could do it for a fight, why sparring?
Okay, yeah, what happens in a fight? He said that Vergil knows what would happen. That's what he said.
Yeah,
right?
Well.
He said.
Well, the only difference, look, we're usually good about Ryan, even if he's.
Yeah,
you know,
Ryan's a good dude.
But, no, fuck him. But, seriously, because look, we're good about not saying stuff about him.
Yeah, I stuck up for him when I didn't.
Yeah, Vergil stuck up for him.
I ain't fucking shit for no reason. I like him.
Talking all that shit. Look, in the amateurs, when he got that split decision, I was on the judging thing, and his mom was on the judging thing. He'd get the edge. But smoke him. You try to be good about things, and you know how many people have already beating the amateurs that are big names right now? He's beat the majority of those guys. And it's like, he's calling him a pussy, this and that, when I don't give a fuck what's wrong with him. What's coming out of him is what he is. That's how he's always been. We just being good about it. But I promise you, if there's a fight, I would encourage Vergil to bet everything that he has versus everything that he has.
Guaranteed.
You put the whole purse on the line.
No,
hey, Vergil, the whole purse on the line?
Easy.
Look, the thing is that he says this and he says that, and it's never his fault. Whenever he fought Tank and he got hurt to the body, this Vergil's the 154. He's a real puncher. The guy that hurt him was what's that kid's name from Mongolia?
Yeah. He's actually going to the Olympics.
He is?
He's trying to make the Olympics.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, he's 5'2".
He went over there and he dropped him. He dropped him to the body. So when Genghis dropped him to the body, he came to the gym and he told all of us. So he didn't have a mole in his pants. He didn't have no. Genghis Khan came in and was laughing. He goes, all day.
I was there that day. I happened to be there that day.
So what happened was, since he dropped Ryan, and Genghis Khan is a 120 something?
126.
They kicked him out of the gym. So he wasn't allowed to go back.
You know, now he trains there, ironically.
And then he's sparring small guys like Louis, and he broke Louis' jaw. Louis at 120-something.
Ryan did,
so,
Ryan.
Yeah, so, I mean, Vergil's not at 126-100. I tell you, and I'm being honest.
Nah, that's, in reality, Vergil hurts him.
In three rounds.
Bad. Vergil bad. Yeah, Vergil does hurt him.
In three rounds, Vergil hurts him. And I'll even tell you this. Vergil probably, and he probably slows it down to the fifth round just to hurt him. Just a fucking hurdle. And we've been pretty good about that.
I would bet that if Vergil does knock him out, we don't get paid.
If Vergil does knock him out, he doesn't get paid. And I tell you why we're
exactly,
like,
bro.
Why not?
Because I tell you why I'm being like this. Because, you know, my mom sees all these videos. And that's what Vergil doesn't actually do. You know, for him to be calling him a pussy and this and that. And my mom's like, Vergil's a good kid. Like, what? Why is he doing that?
Yeah.
It's disrespectful to us, you know, considering that I know his dad. I've been good with his dad. You know, when they were getting signed to Golden Boy, you know how they were getting signed to Golden Boy? He was riding Oscar and telling Oscar, oh, I beat Vergil. It was always about Vergil. Ask Oscar him. See, I don't ever say stuff like this. It's always about that. So, you know, like, if he has that kind of jealousy towards him, fuck it. Tell him in his face. Don't be like that about it, you know? Like, we have no reason to be jealous of this dude. We felt that since they came from the same era, the same, you know, we should all support each other. But all this time, we've been knowing that he's been saying things. We just don't ever say nothing. But if he wants to run, it's beautiful.
We could do it next year.
To be honest, Vergil, every fighter always says, I'll put my purse on the line, but they never do. But in this case, you guys would do it. The whole purse. What if it's 25 million?
Then Vergil's going to be 25 million more richer.
Exactly.
And if he doesn't knock him out, Vergil doesn't get paid. And I swear to God,
Vergil knocks him out.
I mean it.
Yeah, it's true. There's no fucking doubt.
I swear to God on my kids, I mean it.
What about his left hook?
And I'll tell you what it's going to be. It's going to be with a body shot to the left. It's going to be with a left body shot. I'm telling you right now.
He's picking it like Babe Ruth picked the angle where the ball's flying. You're calling it.
Vergil hurts.
What about Ryan's left hook?
Ryan is, you know, like I told you, I honestly, he knows, you know, that I've always respected him. I like him. I actually, you know, we support him when he fights. Fucking Bear was fucking crying when he lost to Tank. You know, we support him. Because I've known him from Southern California. He's always been cool with me, and his parents have always been great people. But he's got no chance against Vergil. Honestly, he's got no chance.
Him, right? We don't lie. Right?
He's
Vergil,
got no chance.
Vergil's
the one against Vergil. He's got no fucking chance against Vergil.
He don't even have one.
He's got no chance against Vergil.
He don't have a puncher's chance.
That's a fail. He's got no chance against
Vergil. He don't. Fucking God couldn't save him. Enough.
Okay, let me ask you this: do you believe the fight will ever happen?
No.
Because
they won't take it. They're not
going to
take it. That's all for show. It's all
yeah,
for show.
They won't take it. They won't. And they shouldn't, actually. Because they'll get hurt.
I'm saying he'll take it. I don't care about that stuff. It's, once you start acting that way, you know, like it's different, man.
I know he was coming. He was in
person. Yeah, like on social media. And my mom sees stuff. And my mom's like, you know, he's an old lady. But you know, the reason why we don't act that way, because we know he has a mom and this and that, but, you know, if he's going to be acting that way and using excuse about, or if people want to give him excuse because he's drunk, I don't want to hear that shit, man. You are who you are when you drink. You are who you are when you drink. Calling people the N-word and look, you see that he don't even have black security now for the next one because he burned himself?
I heard, but I didn't see what he said.
That's
he said
the N-word. Yeah. When you have that kind of platform and you have that kind of influence, you shouldn't be like that. You should be influenced, you know, for your generation, for these guys of the boxers, for the people. And he's not. He's about himself. He always will be.
The guy looks like Mr. Burns from The Simpsons.
No. He needs to eat that food.
It's a prank. Everybody's making weight because they're fighting this week. Robert, hey, out of all the fighters you guys have ever seen, who has the easiest time to make weight, in your opinion? Not heavyweights. Your fighter that's always on weight, that never...
Everybody has to cut weight. The only one that I've seen, but Mayweather, he would always walk around his weight.
Pacquiao.
No, I think Pacquiao did cut a little bit.
You think so?
Not too much, but a little bit. Mayweather was always walking around his weight class. Sometimes he went in and then the fight day, it was lighter because that's his natural weight. But everybody else cut weight, man. Everybody has to cut weight.
Yeah. Is that the hardest part of boxing, making weight?
The week of the fight,
because
everybody's always hurting. The week of the fight, it's always
going to
be hard for everybody.
And some guys have injuries, right? And they're trying to make weight in that injury.
Yeah, a lot of stuff. See, the thing is that you're training for 2 months. So most of the fighters always say 100%. There's no fight.
Okay.
Because you always have some kind of an injury, some kind of a, you know, either you know, or you could have got sick a couple, because when you're losing so much weight, your system is low. So you get sick very easy too.
Your immune system.
Yeah. So
one time, my Dana,
I need to go send some shirts.
Okay. My Dana for the Mayweather rematch came in like 70 pounds over. Am I exaggerating, Robert?
What?
When my Dana came back to camp for the rematch.
Yeah?
No, he was huge. He told me you could film me, but only from the neck up. Yeah, and I did. I filmed him the whole camp from the neck up. Yeah. He was working out. He was throwing punches. But here's the fucked up part. The press conference was at a restaurant, and they had all the food right in front of it. Robert, you remember that?
Yeah.
We were sitting at a restaurant, and he was eyeing the food. He was starting to eat. He couldn't help himself.
It's hard. Yeah,
that's
like,
messed up.
Like, whenever Virgil's making weight, we try not to eat in front of him.
Yeah, you're right.
It's just, you know, you just don't want to eat in front of him. It makes you feel bad. And then when he's making weight, like the last 2 days, I won't be around him.
Yeah, yeah.
First of all, I don't work weight. I don't work on it. But I don't like watching him
struggle
and losing weight and then us eating. So I don't do that. I try to stay away. And then he's a little grouchy too.
Yeah, everybody's grouchy. I miss breakfast, so I'm grouchy.
I remember you used to make weight and you fucking hit somebody else in front of you eating or drinking something. So I always try to say, you know, I haven't done it lately, but I used to.
I remember.
I used to.
Make weight with?
I used to stay without breakfast until after the weigh-in. I would do it because I know what the fight was going through. I would just wait till after the weigh-in, then I would go eat. Because, you know, that was just, I did that for many years. You know, now if I go have a burger, I'm not going to go with the fighter. I'm not going to eat in front of him. You know what I mean? Because I know if I just see somebody else drinking water,
okay.
Fucking.
So why the fighters?
And then there's teammates. There's teammates that are fucking assholes that fucking actually do it on purpose. They come around you with a fucking soda. It's true.
That's why I thought this.
Exactly.
What?
fucking hour ago.
That's just not right. That's just not
right.
That's
just not right.
No, that's just not right.
Why are you burning him?
Eating a fucking salad.
Wait, he wants you to eat healthy.
Yeah, I don't like to do that. That's why when on weekday, I don't want to eat with my brothers. I want to fuck. I eat
because it doesn't make you comfortable.
Exactly. It doesn't. You feel bad.
Guilty.
Yeah, nah, fuck that. I try to step away from that shit.
Unless you're Felipe, you don't fucking eat.
No. Dude. Robert had a fighter, Yevgeny. I think he was always under his weight.
Yeah, he cut a little bit. But
yeah. But he was in a bad mood all the time.
That's like 1 pound you have with the weight.
Hey, you better not wear that underwear to the weigh-in.
Right.
Yeah.
That's a bad luck. Yeah. Don't wear that brand to the weigh-in. You can wear it now. You can wear it afterwards. There's a track record of fighters. That's good. You almost on weight.
I feel great too.
Hey,
did you touch him already?
Who?
I can't never pronounce his name.
I thought he was from Spain or Cuba somewhere.
No, he's from Africa. South
but he speaks Spanish?
But he speaks Spanish.
¿Cómo se llama el dominicano que era campeón del mundo? La avispa de Colón.
Si es de África, ahora es Spanish.
El dominicano que era... What's that? Ryan Beatle.
Javier Fortuna.
Fortuna, he can look like Fortuna.
He does it. Fortuna is southpaw. Yeah.
Okay, let's get Primo.
Oh, by the way, this weekend, did you guys see Oshaki Foster get robbed? He won every round except one.
I heard about it, but I didn't see it.
I didn't see the fight because I was at the fight. Okay. But I think you know, the judges were, I heard the judges were very green. They didn't have a lot of world title experience. And from what I seen from the point, you know, they do what's called when they do the count, the number of points.
CompuBox.
What's his name? Consecao threw like double the punches that the other guy threw. So maybe the judges counted that, you know, that he was just busier.
Yeah.
Maybe didn't land everything.
But it looked.
And from what I understand, from what I've seen, Foster fight, you know, he boom, one at a time, two at a time, doesn't throw too much. So maybe his punches landed more. His percentage was probably bigger because he threw a lot less, but landed.
So it looked like he was the busier guy, yeah.
But the other guy was just too busy that maybe that's what the judge has seen. You know, I don't know. I don't know Foster, and I've seen him fight, and he fucking stocked it up when he became champion. So I was happy for him. I was proud of him, and I like his corner too because his trainer is a great dude. You know, he's worked his ass off to make it to where they're at right now. But I'm also happy for Consecao. His fourth title opportunity, he became champion now. So now he's a world champion. You know, there's nothing you could take away from that.
Do they have a rematch clause?
They should have. I don't know if they had a rematch clause, but they should.
They should do a rematch.
Because a lot of people, mostly everybody thought Foster won. But I'm telling you, the judges were a little too green when it came to title fights. So if they see Consecao just staying busy, even though he wasn't landing, but just threw so many punches, that was a lot of that they gave him.
Maybe not the right. But what do you always say, Robert? Try not to leave it in judges' hands if you can.
You know,
hard to do sometimes.
Myself, I could agree that you don't win punches. You don't win a fight by just throwing a lot of punches. But if that's the way the judges see it, then you gotta respect it. You gotta respect it, man. You know, what can we say? Fucking Bam was behind. I'm one of the judges.
The fuck?
And one had a draw, but one had Bam behind.
But that means that if that's the case, the fight ends right there, it's a draw.
Exactly, that sucks.
And everybody would have been okay with it.
Imagine there's a headbutt and you have to end it because of the headbutt and you're behind and it would have been a draw for a bout.
But I'm saying the boxing fans, I hear, it's boxing. What does that mean? Yeah. Like, does that mean it's okay,
no,
Robert?
No, it's not okay for us, but for the world,
but for the world, they were like, it's okay if he gets robbed.
And if we would have ended up with a draw, then guess what? Guy was still the champion, so we're fucked.
Maybe that's what they wanted to do.
So no, you know, I'm glad, you know.
That was a beautiful body shot.
We'd have to go to the scorecards because it looked like it was that going that direction where they wanted to rob Bam.
Did you watch the fight again?
I watched it a few times.
How do you love that first body shot and the second one?
Every round, man, it's just since the beginning. Every round was beautiful. Even when he got dropped, that was a badass round for Bam. He got dropped, so he lost the round, but it was a badass round.
That was a flash knockdown, but yeah.
Yeah, but he still got dropped, you know, which is actually good that it happened because he said it, and you know, I didn't have the mic with me because, right away, when you have the, like, we go to ESPN, all the camera crew, they know who we are. So, Robert, you know, I need to mic you, so fuck it, let's do it. But this time, when the camera guy says, like, okay, who's the trainer? Right, okay, this motherfucker doesn't know what he's doing. Yeah. So we pointed at Felipe.
Did he talk at all?
No, he was down. He's the one that was down there.
So, they couldn't hear.
So they couldn't hear.
That's why they didn't go to your corner.
They came during the round, and they're like, hey, is it on? Or can we roll in?
Yeah, they
couldn't hear him, so they came in.
How does it feel to be famous?
So it was Felipe that had it.
I like that.
Nothing what I was saying. But see, the run before he got dropped, I told Bam Bam, you're getting, you know, even though he won, you know, he was winning, but I said, look, you're getting a little too careless. We're still halfway through. So this motherfucker's got 6 more rounds. He's got experience. He could be dirty. You know,
40, 28 knockouts,
don't
right?
Don't fucking take it too light. He's like, he doesn't hit hard. He doesn't hit hard. I said, yeah, but still, don't get too careless. Don't get too comfortable. Because Bam was already like just walking in and boom, you know, doing his thing. And then the next run is when he gets dropped. So I go, see what I told you? He's like, yeah, that's good. But it's actually good.
Good experience, yep.
Because if it was somebody else that drops him, yeah. Somebody that keeps coming stronger, anything, then we could have been in trouble. You know what I mean? You know, so I'm glad it happened early. Now he knows. He knows that.
Okay, so what are Bam's options? I saw a guy from Argentina that just won in Japan.
Puma, that's what we want. But
that's Chino Maidana's guy.
Yeah, I already know.
You tell, what did Chino say?
Nah, they want that fight too. Hopefully.
That's a big one.
I know he also had a rematch to us, but I don't know if Ioka is gonna ask for a rematch. We know fucking Guy already wants it, so we have to, unless Guy wants to wait a little bit longer and we fight Puma first, and
then
we fight Gaio next year, that'd be fucking badass.
But Puma Bam is unification, they're each champions.
Yeah, it'll be a unification.
He went to Japan and won, which is very hard to do.
Give him.
Hey, his name is Wilson.
Wilson. How you feeling, Wilson?
Where are you from, Wilson?
Angola.
Where are you?
How come you're there?
That's in the southwest of Africa.
Southwest
near
Africa.
Congo.
Okay.
Yeah.
How many languages do you speak?
Four.
Tell me which ones.
French, Portuguese, English, and Spanish.
Why do you speak so many languages?
Traveling.
I travel. I barely speak English.
School and traveling.
He speaks Spanish. He's a really smart man.
That's badass.
How did you learn Spanish? How?
My primary language is Portuguese, so when I came here, I've always been around the Hispanic community, so I picked that up.
You can tell he's a smart man right there. Yeah.
What, you said Senegal?
Angola.
Okay, it's near, because Senegal near, speaks French.
Senegal is in north.
Yeah,
how long have you been in the States?
For 10 years.
Wow.
Yeah.
How old are you?
26.
Okay, so for 10 years you've been in the States already?
Yeah, 10 years.
Did you come from your country to the States?
Yes. Okay. From Angola. Good. 2013.
Where are you from? Where do you train out of? What city?
Dallas.
Oh, shit. Oh, I didn't know that. Okay, so you know them.
Yes.
Well, okay, tell them about Vergil Ortiz.
Vergil Ortiz. He has power, monstrous power.
You sparred him?
I never sparred him.
But no, you saw it?
I've seen it. I've seen it.
And what's your thing about prediction for his fight?
Sorry?
Your prediction for his fight, Vergil Ortiz and
I think he's going to drop him with the body shot. The next fight.
Body shot, you're calling it?
Yeah.
What about Ryan Garcia and Vergil? Ryan wants to come and spar him.
Yeah, Ryan Garcia, Vergil will be too much for him.
Ryan's confident.
Yeah, Vergil will be too much. I don't think it will be an easy walk for Ryan if he faces Vergil.
Are you here by yourself or you came with your old family?
In the States, I came with my family. Some of them went back, but I'm here with my oldest brother and my wife. I'm married now, so my
congratulations.
Wife.
How long you been boxing?
For 6 years.
And you love it?
I love it, man.
Who do they compare you with? Like, do you fight like Mayweather? Do you fight like Pacquiao? Do you fight like...
Usually, a main fighter, like Pitbull Cruz, like kind of style of fight.
You fight like Pitbull, that's perfect.
Yeah, yeah.
Tell people your name one more time.
Wilson Akinosho.
And Wilson, where do they follow you at?
Huh? Wilson Akinosho.
Where do they follow you on social media?
Where
do
they follow you on social media?
Wilson Akinosho.
Is Wilson your real name? Wilson, your birth name when you were born?
My real name, yeah. Wilson Akinosho. You look that up, you'll find me.
All right. Wilson.
Wilson. Wilson! What movie is that from?
I'll tell you, Tom Hanks, was it?
Tom Hanks.
On the island.
When he's lost in the Castaway.
Castaway.
Wilson!
That was a good movie. Tom Hanks was a good actor.
I love Tom Hanks. He's a good actor.
Well, so which fights were you at? Golden Boy?
No, I was in Bronzeville.
Oh shit, I didn't realize
Bronzeville,
that.
But I did his promotions. We had Panterita.
Yeah.
We had Caleb Zuniga. We had Inicio and Sammy. All for one.
No, they're all great kids. They all need these fights to get better.
Exactly.
Before you know it, they'll be on pay-per-view one day.
We have to build them a little bit.
Yeah. So that's really cool. So you have this weekend four fights?
Four fights again, yeah.
And then a couple weeks later, it's...
Then we have on the 20th right now, so right now it looks like Felix Soria. Then August 3rd, August 10th. And right there, that's where... Oh, no, August 31st. Leo, August 31st in Mexico City. August 10th, also the same day that Vergil fights in New Mexico. We have Lindolfo Delgado, Chop Chop. That's it, right? Chop Chop in Lindolfo, that? In New Mexico?
Where's where's Duarte, by the way?
Duarte gets here on the 15th.
I think Duarte's probably going to fight Jose Ramirez's card. When is Jose? Jose, they said he's fighting...
sometime in September.
Yeah, no, but I saw a name. I saw Rick put out that they
spent,
yes.
Well, 29. Maybe. I don't know if it's already official, but that's what but they said some, they're looking into a date in September, so that's perfect.
You know what I heard? I heard Munguia might go to top rank. I don't know if it's real or not, but if it does happen.
Where did you hear that?
There's boxing this weekend at
what
the fight.
What with Golden Boy?
I don't know.
He is with Golden Boy.
Okay, so maybe he's with Golden Boy.
I don't know. All I know is he's been fighting
people say
Boy.
Stuff, but I don't know
yeah,
if it's true.
I have no idea.
But definitely it's an exciting time for boxing. And you were happy for Nate Diaz. He got down.
Yeah, fuck yeah, Nate Diaz got down.
He threw a lot of punches.
He's good too, so we gotta support him too. He's from California. He's from Northern California, but we're from South. That's fine. He's with my compa, my compa's from Spain.
You remember one day his brother Nick came to your gym?
Yeah.
His brother told me they used to watch Robert Kershaw reality show, and that's
yeah,
why he came to train with you. But you weren't at the gym that day.
Yeah, I remember that. I remember they told me about it.
He's very popular. Yeah. He's still fighting.
Yeah, but I'm happy that he won. You know, that was a good win for him. I don't know the other guy. I've heard his name, but I never.
Masvidal.
Yeah.
Well, they fought in MMA the first time.
They
Masvidal won that one.
Oh, okay, I didn't
know that. So now they fought in boxing. Now they could do a third one or. So
and
check this out.
Good crowd, right?
Packed. 18,500.
Amado also won.
Yeah, that was a great fight. That was entertaining. By the way, Conor McGregor bet $500,000 on Nate to win back $1.6 million.
I know, I heard that.
Would you ever bet $500,000?
I don't bet. It's a big risk. Some people do. Maybe Conor has that kind of money.
He
does.
That's why
people gamble $20 million, you know, because they have that money. That's why Canelo's donating $30 million to charity, you know, because he's got that kind of money. You know, we could probably donate $30. You know what I mean? We could probably bet $100 because, you know, it's just levels.
I don't know when they say celebrities donate, Robert. I don't know. It sounds good. Tyson Fury said that after the first Wilder fight, he donated his entire purse to the homeless. There's not one homeless person yet to come forward and said he got a dollar. So they say stuff that sounds... I'm not saying in this case it could be. But I'm saying they say stuff, but...
Yeah, well,
when you do charity, I believe you should just do it quietly anyways and not...
Yeah, true. When we do stuff, it's...
Nobody knows.
Quietly. You know, nobody sees none of that stuff, you know. But, you know, but from what... You know, okay, when we hear, you know, some people donate $30 million, some people donate 30. It depends on
what you can afford.
You can afford.
Okay, a true story, Robert. I'm walking in New York in Brooklyn, and this old lady comes up to me. She said, "Ellie," I go, "Yeah." She goes, "Thank you, Robert and Mikey, because during COVID, you guys send me a card of $100.
Oh, is that right? Because I've met people from Texas that
said the same thing.
You really helped us out during the.
I sent out all the envelopes, of course. Yeah. It was thousands of dollars.
People have approached me. Hey, I was one of those people that
It was real.
Yeah, during the pandemic. Yeah.
That's really nice.
That's awesome.
And then when I called some of the sanctioning bodies because they were honoring people who did stuff in the community, oh, we don't know if it's real. There you go. I just wanted because if you're already honoring, like, it was nice that you and Mikey.
We do it.
I know.
Because it's something that we
nice to give back.
About. You know, there's celebrities that really lie about stuff like that. And
I don't know if they lie. I just don't know if they just say it because they mean it.
Yeah.
But I don't know if they follow through with it. Because
maybe
they meant it for that minute.
Mm-hmm. Well,
but like I said, I don't like when people feed the homeless on their own and take
and
a selfie. Haney did that and Kambosos did that. I don't like that. If you're going to do it, just do it.
That shit don't look good. You fucking have your camera, you feeding
Yeah,
out.
Yeah.
That shit don't look good.
Tank did a giveaway a few months back. Not one video. From the event.
Yeah, and a giveaway, something, you know, where, okay, people are coming in. Okay, that's
Don't
fine.
Embarrass them,
but,
yeah.
But a lot of people go to, like, you see in the street.
Yeah.
And then
Here,
you know.
Listen, I've been around Manny Pacquiao. He'll actually tell you, and Broner's the same way. Turn off the camera.
Yeah.
And then they'll give the guy $100, $50, $20, but not on camera. They don't want it on camera.
That's true.
By the way, Manny looks like he will fight.
Yeah?
Barrios.
Barrios.
And also, Manny lost a lawsuit. This company was signed Mikey, or they were trying to talk to Mikey about fighting Pacquiao.
Right.
They sued Manny for the contract, whatever. They won $5 million. Now Manny won appealed in a higher court. The judge says they didn't have a license to manage in California. So right now he doesn't have to pay the $5 million.
Good for him.
Yeah, it's...
And he is going to fight. It looks like they mentioned the kid from Texas for the WBC title.
Yeah, Barrios.
Yeah, that's cool.
Do you have any 47s over here?
Oh.
For the winner.
No. No, you know, Barrios is in a world champion, so that's different levels.
Bro. Who wins?
Cactus 45, man. Fuck, I don't think, you know, fuck. He still has some left, because, you know, but at 45... I don't see myself at 45 minutes. And when was the last time he fought?
He has exhibitions every 6 months. No, he does exhibitions. Yes. He's supposed to have one now coming up.
Barrios is young, hungry, strong. So I have to pick Barrios, man.
So Robert, one more thing I want to ask you. So how does Charles working? Like right now he's working with your fighters. How did you guys team up? I know he came with Jose.
He came with Jose when Jose came to us.
Yeah.
And right away he knew this is where I belong. And he bought a house locally. Now he lives here.
Who's he work with from your team?
Everybody. Everybody.
Mikey, Vergil.
He works with all my fighters. Everybody.
By the way, you remember a few years ago I brought Danny Trejo to your gym?
Yeah.
And he was here with Baby Bash. Did you see the video of him getting in a fight?
What happened there? Because they were in a parade or
yeah,
something.
Yeah, it's a parade and a convertible.
Somebody threw a water balloon.
They said there was bleach in it. Chemicals. So he got up and he started a fist fight. He's 80 years old. He still got down, but the guy dropped him.
Oh, he got dropped? I didn't see
and his
video,
friend got knocked
but
out.
But I read a little bit about that.
His friend got
but the thing is that, you know, but it's a tradition, right? That they throw
water, but it's a convertible.
So there was something else?
That's what I heard.
Well, there was something else somebody was trying to hurt, you know.
Or, no, but bleach would take the paint off your
See, but even Danny Trejo, you're an 80-year-old. You're on a parade. Don't throw balloons at Danny Trejo. It's like if my dad is on a parade. Even though it's a tradition to throw, you know, what. Don't throw it to an 80-year-old, man. Come on, that's disrespectful. Of course,
it's not a wet t-shirt contest.
Of course, Danny Trejo got mad. You don't do that to an 80-year-old.
But he got down, 80 years old.
Yeah, he's not afraid.
What would the big G do?
Oh, he would pull out his gun. Ready. My dad's always trapped.
He always, he's ready to go.
He doesn't give a fuck.
He enjoyed Bam's fight. I talked to him. He loved it.
Oh, fuck yeah.
And now, you don't know what's next. Nothing official. You're waiting to hear if Guy wants for Bam.
Whoa. He said it right there that he wants a rematch.
They
so
always say that, but
if he decides to wait a little bit longer, then obviously Puma, Martinez, that's the fight we want. It's a unification.
Okay, so Vergil's fight is now official, but we kind of knew he was fighting. What's the guy, Sergey Durenchek? Is that the guy?
Yeah, Sergey something.
Okay, have you been studying him?
Well, I've watched his fights.
What do you think about him?
Strong kid. Very strong, great condition. He's hungry. He's one of those Eastern European guys that they just come to fight, man. They come to fight. They're strong. Mentally, physically, always going to be strong. So, it's going to be a good fight.
Between him and Vergil, it's like, I would say, 44 knockouts?
Oh, imagine. Yeah,
yeah if
right.
you put all the knockouts.
That guy's 24-1 with 23 knockouts, and Vergil's 21-0 with 21 knockouts. God damn.
44 knockouts.
In 45. In 44 knockouts in 45 fights.
We just sold the fight for them. That's the poster, Robert. It's called Fireworks.
Yeah.
At the explosion.
Can't wait.
Okay. Eminem is performing on when Ryan was fighting. Which Mexican artist would you pick if you had to pick a Mexican artist? Peso Pluma?
At this moment right now, Fierman, somebody like Peso Pluma.
Santa Fe Clan?
That guy's doing good too. Or the other new guys, Yair something. They're new. They're
popular?
One of them, Yair something. He's from right there where I was at over there. Brownsville, the border town, Tamaulipas, Reynosa, Tamaulipas.
Very popular?
So he's very popular. He's big time right now. So maybe, you know, one of those hot guys right now. I think Fidme is not as hot as they are right now. So either Peso Pluma or Yair.
I think if they did that, I think it would help a lot. I think the crowd would go. Because Eminem's cool, he's a legend, but your demographics would be all Mexican-American.
You have to have Mexicans.
You have to.
Because I think 80% are going to be Mexicans.
95. Yeah. They're gonna see Pitbull, Ryo, and Andy. Yep, in LA.
Yeah, 90% of them are Mexicans. So they should have somebody a Mexican or somebody that's, you know, one of those fucking classic ones like Tigres del Norte, you know, Ramon Ayala, something like that too. That would be big too.
Let me ask you this: Does what's the name? Fernando, the one who passed away. Right? Fernando
passed away.
No, the singer. He was a legend. He loved boxing.
Vicente Fernandez.
Does he have a cover band or a son or someone to sing? So why not his son? Because sing his dad's song.
His son is huge too.
But I'm saying something like that.
Yeah, his son is
huge. The fans will go crazy for that.
His son is huge too. But for that, for the fight atmosphere, I think it'd be better somebody else. You know, somebody like Peso Pluma.
Just more club-like, yeah, yeah.
Or if you want to go classic, somebody like Ramon Ayala where people are drinking. Alejandro's more of a like a romantic type of guy. So he does concerts. Fucking chicks love him. I've been to his concerts, actually. I took my wife to one of his concerts. He gets down. He gets down. But for an event like a boxing fight...
Hype. You need energy.
Something like a big old banda or something.
Yeah. I think they should do it. I think it'll make a big difference. It's outside.
Yeah. It wouldn't be a bad idea. Banda Record or something like that.
So how much have you been studying Pitbull too?
I watch him all the time. But, you know, he's always going to be the same. You know, I watch the good thing about him, the bad things about him. I've been watching his fights, you know, against Cabrera, against Rollins, against Tank. Even though Tank had a little bit of a problem, whatever, I still got to
watch Tank came him. In the fight with one hand. I was with him like whatever, the week of the fight. But still he did.
Yeah. You know, so I got, you know... But, you know, he's a tough kid, man. He's a tough kid. You got to respect him. He's
a champion.
Well, I'm pretty sure when they first brought him to fight Tank, everybody thought, oh, Tank's going to look good. Sir. And that fight right there blew him up.
He made him a superstar. Tank said a star was born.
Now he's a world champion. They did the right thing with him, too. They picked the right opponent to become champion. He's a world champion.
And that's it.
So I think at 135, I think... You know, the 135 champions right now would probably beat him, except for the new guy, the WBO. Maybe he beats that guy. But the rest, I think, would probably beat him.
All right, but let's see what happens. August 3rd, and then August 10th.
A lot going on in the next
few months. Yeah, have you talked to Rick at all?
Rick who?
Meridian.
He's been calling me fucking...
20 times
like
a day?
20 times already. Look, I'll tell you how many guys...
You know, Robert, can I give
you... See, right here, Rick. Look at all those cards. Look, it's all him. Look, it's all him. And two times, you know, he's been calling me.
I'm going to give you a business idea that he's not going to like.
Why not?
Because I'm going to tell you. Can you get a 1-900 number for your cell phone?
A 1-900?
Whenever people call you, you make $5 a minute.
We can't do that.
Why not?
No,
Do you like the idea? Virgil. Rick calls him 20 times a day. What if Robert got a 1-900 number, $5 a minute? How much money would he make per day? I told Broner to do that.
Did he call you early in the morning?
He's been calling me 30 to
5 a.m. Well, he works very hard and he's very good. He gets results.
Yeah, Rick,
yeah, he's
consistent. No, Broner gets about 300-400 calls a day. So I told Broner to do it because people call him the bullshit. Why not make some money in the process? You don't think so, Robert? It's not a good idea? Not for you. You're a coach and you work, obviously. I'm joking. But if people already want to call, it's like, what's the name of that thing where celebrity gives shout outs? Cameo? This is like Cameo. Yeah, but the atmosphere, the Nate fight was over amazing. Really, the crowd was 99% Nate Diaz fans.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, they went crazy, yeah. That's cool. And all his, except one, all his stable mates won.
Leo! Where'd Leo go? Did Leo leave?
Okay, so if we all come visit your country, what do we see? Yeah. Wilson. Angola? Yeah, Angola. What do we see?
You're going to see there's a beautiful waterfall over there.
Okay.
Beautiful... beautiful people.
Is it safe?
I need a picture of your passport. Your dad also.
Okay. It's not a lot on the news, which I guess is good, right?
It's good, yeah. It's not known for a lot.
So it should be the same.
But it's a good place to relax.
Leave Felipe and your dad.
It's not a fast-paced area.
Who's the most famous athlete from Angola?
Must be
a soccer player, yeah.
Aqua. That was one of the legends of Angola.
But anything current, recent?
Recent, no, not recent.
How many people live there?
I don't know. I don't know much about the population.
Yeah.
No, I don't know the population.
What's the best food out there?
I'm becoming more and more Texan, so.
How many people live in Dallas?
I don't know either, man.
Was it 4 million or 7 million?
I'm not sure, man.
Okay, let me ask you this. What's the food in Angola? What are we eating?
You have makayabu.
Which is what?
It's made out of okra and okra. You know okra?
Okra.
You don't know okra?
Okra.
Oprah?
Okra.
What is that?
Okra.
It's a little... they fry, you know what fried okra is? Like okra?
Yeah, so...
Is that a fish?
It's a vegetable.
Vegetable? Okay.
Yeah, and if you cook it enough, it becomes very gooey. It's good. We have kizaka. That's actually something that comes from Congo also. Congo and Angola, they share the kizaka. It's made out of cassava leaves.
Okay, vegetarian. Yeah. I love it. Robert, let's go.
Yeah, let's go. You're welcome. Stay.
Good beaches.
Good beaches over there.
Is it a tourist?
Benguela. Benguela is a place of where you have to be.
Is it a tourist destination? A lot of people
It does, yeah. It does have a tourist destination.
That's cool.
People are... are friendly there.
That's why your family moved back.
Yeah, yeah. They were here for about three, four years, and then decided to go back.
Why did you stay?
I got married. I found love.
Mexican?
A Mexican.
Yeah? Nice.
She kept me here.
Now you like the Mexican food?
Yeah, Mexican food, yeah.
Oh, so you married a Mexican?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, yeah.
And you speak Spanish? Of course you do.
Yeah, I speak Spanish.
If not, you would have left too?
Yeah. Yeah, because around the time where the family was deciding to go back, I was ready with her. So I was like, nah, I'll just
stay. How often do you go back?
We went back last year. We planned
with her?
Yeah.
You took her?
She loved
nice.
It.
She loved it?
She tells me, hey, let's go back again.
For real?
Yeah, often.
Nice.
So the plan is hopefully by the end of the year, go visit beautiful. Again. My mom loves her, family loves her.
Nice. That's
okay, great. Let me ask you a quick question. Wilson, so I go over there. Everybody speaks Portuguese. Do they speak English?
Some people
so
do.
Portuguese is the language?
Yeah, Portuguese is the main language over there. Yeah, some people do because of the oil business. A lot of people, French, Portuguese, and English. It's spoken, but not much, but you'll find some people that do.
They have the wells over there, right? They drill.
Yeah, the wells.
It's a big business, Robert. All the billionaires.
Yeah.
That's so cool. Yeah.
That's awesome. You should get kids? A well.
Huh? Kids? That's next in the list. Yeah.
That's
next.
That's awesome.
That's nice. Great. All right. Are you the number one boxer from Angola right now?
Right now, I think so. I believe so. They're not big in boxing, so.
And today you were here for Ryu. Ryu's getting ready for Pitbull.
Yeah,
so,
right.
So your girl.
Yeah.
She's a wife, right?
Yeah, my wife.
You leaving? Uh-huh. Was fine with her?
Yeah, it was fine with her. She wanted me to stay a bit. She was like, can I come with you? I was like, I'm not going to have fun. But just a week, and I mean, later you'll come back and have fun.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm not gonna say who because everybody watches the videos.
Yeah.
But there's some guy that sometimes comes to the gym that took his girlfriend to a recent fight just to show her why she should never come again.
Oh,
it's true, right? Yeah. You're busy, you're working.
Uh-huh.
It's not like
it's not time to.
It's not a party. It looks like it's fun, uh-huh. But it's work.
And that's what the girls think of. Like, oh, you're gonna be there for a whole week. Shit, we're fucking working. We're fucking struggling. We're fucking having a hard time.
It's 110 degrees in the gym right now. I'm sweating without even trying.
Yeah, but that's what a lot of people think. A lot of like girlfriends, the wives.
It's fucking boring.
You're out there having fun. You're out there having fun.
Yeah. You can't do nothing.
That's what they all think.
It sounds cool. So you're going to California to hang out.
I picked him up from the airport yesterday. He dropped his Bible. I know this guy was going to be. Yeah.
Are you religious?
Yeah.
He's a preacher.
Nice. Good for you, man.
We have a church back home.
Good for you. You can tell right away. He's a smart.
Should I do a biblical quiz really quick?
That's good for you, man.
No. You know, I'm going to tell a funny story. So I walk in the gym today and I saw a guy and I looked at him and I asked everybody at the gym, is he with Vado or is he a preacher?
Uh-huh.
And he was a preacher. It was the guy from your church. He was here.
From my church.
That's what people. Felipe. There's a guy.
Who from my church came? I don't go to church.
Some white guy with holding a Bible.
Falcao's a preacher.
Yeah, Falcao's
a preacher.
I ain't no fucking preacher. I don't go to church. They say I have a church.
They said.
To my church.
Yeah, some white guy here. White guy, blonde hair. I thought he was Vada.
I don't know what you're talking about. It was two guys and a lady.
I don't see. I was just a guy. I don't know.
Those are the ones because they have a program like autism.
Okay.
They like to kind of like a non-profit like you have with the kids.
Yeah.
They have for kids.
That's
need.
Amazing. Okay.
Yeah. And they want to team up with me to do like.
That's really nice. Yeah.
So we might once
you at the gym.
There,
yeah.
I came over here because over there I could do shows. So we do stuff like that. Yeah, we could team up to raise money for their
organization.
For their
that's really nice.
Because they also, but it's for autism kids. Do we autism. Have any kids that do? I never even met one.
What?
That has autism. What is the kid?
You probably have. You just said this.
But what is it?
It's on.
How do you know?
It's on a spectrum. Like some people, you might not notice. That might be little small. You know, effects. Other people don't even talk, and they.
Yeah, you know, it's just my daughter. I have a my middle daughter. She has myelo. Okay, she's crazy.
I don't know, but yeah, that's what they wanted.
There's an NBA player. You saw the NBA player on the news. NBA player's son had autism, and it turned out he was an NBA rapper. And he was diagnosed as an adult, now that he's retired, that he has autism, and he was in the NBA.
I never
really let me Google it.
Some of them have it real heavy. Some of them, it's
well, that's what they were here for.
It means, well, sometimes so these kids, Robert.
Once I get back to the new gym, you know, do amateur shows, events like that, because it's going to be, it's actually an event center. We registered it as a boxing gym, but also an event center, so we could have our own events if we want. We could do them outside, you know, outdoor events and shit like that.
You know who that guy is?
No.
Okay, an NBA player. What's his name?
Tony Snell.
Tony Snell, 31 years old, been in the NBA for 10 years, 8 years, whatever. And autism, basically, they're super intelligent, but socially awkward. Is that fair to say something like that?
Some of them are very, very smart, but they just...
Okay. So one feature of autism in the brain is that you have an increased learning ability, actually. You have increased dendritic spine density, which allows more neural connections to be made. That's why some people with autism learn to play the piano.
Yeah, the best piano players.
All these things like that. Because they're really capable of learning, but also they're kind of commonly thrown off socially, right?
Uh-huh.
But you'll see people like...
Too bad none of these fuckers have it, because they sure damn don't know how to go to death.
But you don't know. You don't know, Vergil.
Well, I'm just saying.
We do know one.
Who's that?
Yeah, one guy who played against it.
We? Who is that?
No, don't say on camera. But anyways... But that's very nice, Robert, that they came and that, because if you could do it and they're legit.
I've been talking to him already for a while.
But you know, just make sure they're legit. Just double check and see, right? You have to make sure anything when it comes to charity, especially when money's involved. Like,
yeah,
you just have to make sure, because you're going to go out, make them famous.
Yeah.
Those tips from me.
Yeah.
Makes a big difference.
Wilson, let's talk in Spanish for a second. ¿Cómo estás?
Bien, gracias a usted.
Muy bien. Yeah. Feliz Navidad.
Robert, you could tell. Bien gracias usted, you know.
And you,
like, you know, you could tell he's got good manners. He's an educator.
You could tell he studies, but from the books.
Not like Chop Chop. Like, Portia Gonza, oh, I'm good, my boy.
Hey, ask Misael. A toda madre, cabrón.
You guys say, what did Margarito used to say?
Huh?
Like, pinche novia. What, Margarito, what did he say? Will you ask him how is he feeling?
Oh, sí.
Like a hard dig.
Pito para novia.
Yes.
Yeah.
Margarito, how you feeling?
Pito para novia.
That's what he would say all the time.
Pito para novia. Area.
Listo.
Margarito. By fighting Chavez Omar.
Yeah.
Getting ready.
Yeah.
All right, Vergil. We'll see you. Wilson, nice meeting you. We'll see you next few days, next few weeks. Stay tuned. Miss Ann working very hard.